Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to this playlist where I'm covering JavaScript different miscellaneous topics which are important. In this video we are going to talk about comparison in JavaScript, like you do object compare, you do primitive value compare, how it works in JavaScript. Okay, so here I'm going to talk about like double equals operator we have, then we have triple equals operator, then we have a lot of other things like object dot age. This is also used for object comparison. Okay, so these all different things we are going to talk about, like what is the difference between double equal and triple equal operator. Okay, so let's get started. So we'll start with very basic examples like simple. So what it will be? It will be true, right? So double equals, if you talk about double equals, what actually it does is it actually compares only value. Okay, but when we do triple equals, okay, zero is this, and if I'm trying to compare it using triple equals with this, it will come as false, right? Because you see the type of zero is not equal to type of empty string. That's why both are not same and both are not equal for triple equals, so that is why it is coming as false. Okay, now simple, if you talk about this array and array with value 1, you are trying to compare this with true, it will result true because it is just comparing the value and this turns out as a true. Similarly, I mean, these are some of the weird parts of JavaScript, but when we talk about double equals and triple equals, this is clear that double equals checks only the values and triple equals compares type and value both, like any n, not a number, right? If I do triple equals any n, so value and type both are same, so it will return. So I mean, it's a strange if you just see this why it is coming as false. So triple equals is actually checking the type and value both, and always is triple equals always the best solution? But I mean, whenever you are checking not a number, right, you should always check. I mean, you will never be doing this in your code. You will be doing true false, string boolean comparison, boolean comparison, string comparison, that is valid case. But this is little weird, it is turning out as a false, because when you do type of any n, this you can consider this is an exceptional case, right? So for to avoid all these exceptional cases in JavaScript, you can also use object.is. First of all, we will say what object.is will do. So there is a method object.is, and here you can pass both the arguments. So what I'm passing is, it will turn out as a false. Similarly, we have different examples, and this is most promising solutions. If you just talk about null and undefined, this also turns out as a false. I mean, this should be, because type of null is an object and type of undefined is an undefined. Type of zero is a, you can say, number, and type of empty string is a string, right? So now if you just try to do again for object dot is, and what I'm saying is an, not a number, I'm comparing that with not a number, right? This will give us true. So I mean, this particular case was failing with triple equals, but this is giving us the accurate results, object.is. So the great news that in ES6 there is a object.is which is better and more precise, because, and it has same features like whatever we are having in triple equals. But object.is actually used for object comparison, moreover, object. Okay, so I will just talk about a particular list I have. Let me see. List. Okay, so this is simple list, and here we will talk about when you are doing double equals, triple equals, and object.is. What are the values you will get? I mean, you can clear out your doubts by looking at this table. Undefined, double equals, triple equals, both are true. object dot is also true. So these are the true cases because type and value both are same in first six rows. So either you do with a double equal, triple equals, or object dot is, all are coming as a true. Now coming with this positive zero is a negative zero. This double equals is true, triple equals is also true, object dot is giving false because it is considering the positive and negative number as a different. Okay. Now you see, even triple equals is giving true and object dot is giving false. Yes, positive zero and negative zero will be different, and object dot is giving us the precise result. I mean, you can argue with me like why this positive zero and negative zero is different in JavaScript, but this is how it is. Like this zero and false in double equals, both are true because both are showing the false. Empty string, zero, false, null, undefined, all represents the falsify case. If you just simply write if case, just move it. If you simply write if statement, and here if you write simple empty quotes or false or null or undefined, all things are different, all things are same, representing falsify case. It will never become true, right? Now here we can see all the other results. If we talk about, if you talk, go to the bottom, and not a number and not a number. Object dot is giving us the proper result here. We are getting true. And if you see foo and not a number, obviously all will be false. Zero and not a number, all will give us false because type and value both are different. And zero and null is also false because type of null is an object, and null and zero both are having. So zero is some value. Null is not having any value. So even double equals will also give us false. New string, foo, new string, foo, because these both are different objects. So double equals, triple equals, and object dot is will say, okay, this is different. These are not equals. Here both objects are giving different reference. Here simple objects also, even if you simple compare two different objects in JavaScript, they will never be equals because both are representing different reference. Undefined and false, again a false, because false is a boolean, so having some value. Undefined is not even defined, not having any value at all. So even double equals will be false. Null and false, so if you compare null and false, type of null is object, type of false is a boolean. So obviously triple equals is false. Double equals is also false because false and null are having different values. Similarly, null and undefined. Now you see this. Type of null is object, type of undefined is an undefined. That's why if the types are different, then triple equals will give us false, but double equals is giving true. Similarly, the new string foo and foo, it is giving us the true. So this can also be a surprise that this is representing an object reference, and then like this particular case, double equal is returning false, but in this particular case, it is returning true. Now coming back to the array and the normal values. So if we don't care about the types, both are having the same value, so double equal is true, triple equal is false. 17, 17, I mean the type is different, one is a string, one is a number, but I mean type is different but value is same, so double equal is true. Similarly, the numeric zero and a stringified zero, it is true, but for triple equals it is false. So we should be aware about all these things. I just wanted to cover this particular video just to talk about that object dot is much precise. If you wanted to do object comparison, and if you end up in a situation where you have a uncertainty, then you can just use object dot is. In the daily programming, I know that we don't use object dot is much. We end up like using triple equals that satisfies our condition, because most of the time we deal with the primitives, booleans, objects and all. Okay, so that is fine. Okay, so this is all in this video. Thanks everyone.